I'd rather go and journey where the diamond crescent's glowing, and run across the valley beneath the sacred mountain, and wander through the forest where the trees have leaves of prisms and break the light in colors that no one knows the names of. It's time I'll go and wait beside a legendary fountain till I see your form reflected in its clear and jeweled waters. And if you think I'm ready, you may lead me to the chasm where the rivers of our vision flow into one another. Cascading waters, she may beg, she may plead, she may argue with her logic and mention all the things I lose that really have no value. In the end, she will surely know I wasn't born to follow.
When you see a Silat player, the chances are his knife will be within a heartbeat.
Although knife work is indeed a very important part of the art and ingrained in the structure of KunTao Silat from the beginning of the learning process, it's not the only aspect of KunTao Silat that's critical. The knife, however, is the equalizer that once upon a time the handgun was. In modern America, it's difficult at many times and places to carry a firearm, but a knife is almost always within your grasp, and it can save your life when you need it. KunTao Silat, however, has many other levels. You can simply help people to fall down. You don't have to hurt them in a hard way. You can just simply control them. Or if you don't like what it is that they're doing, you can simply see to it that they're not up in your face. You can simply move them out of your way. There's a whole lot of different aspects to KunTao Silat that are available to the serious student.
They'll throw, boom, boom. See, so you hit here, and then that comes, and then this comes. And then you go down, that comes, is that you sweep.
Often referred to as a phone booth style, KunTao Silat specializes in close quarter combat techniques and using the whole body to hit with. KunTao Silat's blocking mechanisms are also designed to end up right where an opponent is in his worst and most vulnerable positions. The legwork all flows together with it. The idea of weapons disarming, joint locks, leg locks, different sorts of hitting mechanisms and breaking mechanisms are all built right directly into KunTao Silat. So it doesn't really matter what sort of a background you come from, or if you have no background at all, you'll find that KunTao Silat is actually a natural motion system that's designed around the way the body actually works. So you don't really have to learn anything new. All you have to do is to strengthen the structure that you were created with and learn how to use it properly in proper balance and precision and awareness of where your entire body is at all times. It, right from your toes right up to the hair on your chinny chin chin or head or whatever. The idea is always training. you're always doing the same thing. So that your motions, your responses to attacks, that just the way you do things is very consistent. And when you put it into slow motion, you can see where all of the elements of a proper defense are intact at almost every instant of every attack that comes my direction. You see that application of the training, the daily constant training of doing things the way that you want to be able to do them in a fight. You want to have leg work that will support you. You want to have hand work that's not only strong and precise, but also very quick. So that timing is a matter of your choice, not anyone else's. The structure that you find your opponent in is also of critical import in the KunTao Silat perspective. Having the ability to change what your opponent is thinking of doing is a wonderful advantage. And some of the things in KunTao Silat that look like absolutely nothing are actually phenomenal techniques. It's just a matter of knowing how to apply these things and where to apply them. And this comes through daily, constant practice. So your feet are always right where you know where they are. Your hands are always right where you know that they are. Everything in your body is consistent so that you can worry about a whole lot of other things than wondering if your feet are going to be in the right position when you're ready to hit something or change somebody's direction or way of thinking about things. So KunTao Silat is an experience. It's a journey. It's a lifelong endeavor where you just train the way you fight, and you fight the way you train. So there's nothing new you have to learn once you put it all together into your own personal martial lifestyle. Then you'll realize that this is what you've been looking for all along. There is a whole lot of material available in KunTao Silat. There's all of the different KunTao systems, the five houses of the Shaolin, as well as the Northern and the Southern, and the Kwantung and the Shantung, the dragon systems, the praying mantis, all are included in what's called KunTao. Along with the internal arts, the Xingyi, Tai Chi, and Bagua, and all of the Silat arts. What you see there is basically KunTao. KunTao is a mauling art. The whole idea is just to tear things up with overwhelming superiority of strength and agility. And covering all of the different bases where people just don't have the opportunity to hit you. Once they make their first strike, they're suddenly disadvantaged in major ways. And that changes the whole complexion of how a fight's going to go. You know, most people are into an ass-whipping. When they discover that there's a fight in progress, a lot of them will just move out of the way and let you be. You know, which is also a beautiful part of KunTao Silat. You can simply present an armor that will dissuade virtually any sort of a predatory attack. Predators want prey. They don't want to get into a fist fight. They want something that's easy to deal with. And that is not a KunTao Silat player, I guarantee you. So the way KunTao Silat works is you learn by watching. It's the old ancient Chinese Indonesian model of following the leader. That's what makes this so beautiful for the modern day when we have videos where you can actually learn right along with a teacher, but at the same time have at your disposal an instant replay. You got slow motion, you got rewind, you got all these things now that we didn't have when I was learning. You know, I had to learn by following Willem and Chang and Paul and Victor. I had to follow along with them. And when I didn't see something, I didn't get it. That was all there was to it. If you don't see it, you don't get it. But KunTao Silat now, in this video world, makes it available to virtually anybody that is willing to train hard, work hard, and reap the benefits thereof. This is a village style. It's an outdoor art, and you're better off doing it in the clean, fresh air of the outdoors. You practice outdoors where footing is precarious at best. You learn how to step carefully. You learn where your feet are supposed to be. You learn how to balance. You learn how to react to sudden changes. That way your body is actually on autopilot once you inculcate your muscle memory with the stances and the jurus, the handwork we call it, the various forms. Once you get that inculcated into your muscle memory, then it's a simple matter of just training it daily. All the time. Use your stances. Use the opportunities that you have outdoors to train. Get in strange environments, uneven places, and then train. Make training your way of life. Make it your joy. Make it the way you do things. And then, when and if you ever need it, it will be there for you. Train hard, fight easy.
And God bless you all. Thank you for coming to our backyard, and we hope you enjoyed the program.